move around, but a lot of it make these things squeal. And there's so many little leaves down here, I don't know what I'm going to pull out, as it were. Said y'all. Come on now. I hear that Christmas can be tricky when you're a dad, especially when the adverts are particularly sad. You're spawned among the presents you could only dream about, and you have to go and buy them now before they all run out. So here's a cautionary tale, an extraordinary fail. Pass it on to others and perhaps fail. Think twice about the choice of a parenting style. So do allow me please to regale you for a while. Are we sitting comfortably? Then I'll begin. My chubby Super Dicky has a son named Billy, and the young man is really rather good. So when young Billy requested what he really, really wanted for Christmas, Dicky said he would buy whatever it was. But before it recalls, the boy had been as good as gold. But when he found the last one in the supermarket, some other blighter had already grabbed a hold. So they toed and froed between politeness and goading in the aisles of public city stairs, as the pleas for worthiness were heard, and the toy-based grievances were steadily aired. Until Dicky got a little bit overexcited, an argument turned into 50 cups. When I saw what happened, I thought, Dicky, this is really rather risky stuff. As my chum rain blows down upon the chap's head, somebody screams, stop, he's already dead! As the body lay lifeless beneath the strip lighting, it dawned on Dicky how the Christmas was less inviting. The thought of the festive children done up in a cell began to make the protagonist feel a tad unwell. He asked me to tell his son what he'd done. I thought, well, that'll be fun. So I phoned Billy and began with this. Just simply, I saw your father beat a man to death in Tesco's. The buses, they arrived and informed him that he'd best go. Joking for a couple of years or so, he asked if I'd let his daughters and his daddies know that if you want to see your father at Christmas, I wouldn't expect so. Sorry. I'm terribly sorry, Billy. I mean, it really wasn't your father's fault, you know. And if anything, if you're being perfectly honest, you should perhaps blame yourself. It's harsh but true, I know. This is what happened. I saw your father beat a man to death in Tesco's. The brothers, they arrived and informed him that he'd best go. I know the thing that makes you most appalled is that Mr. B was in Tesco's at all. So let's just pretend that the whole thing happened in Waitrose.